Hello, my name is Shirish Rostow and this is my video blog. Yesterday I downloaded a book called Bhasha and how it was made. It was written by Suresh Krishna. I highly doubt it was written by him. I think he dedicated it to someone and he just wrote it. So that's not the matter here. But the thing is, the book is very interesting and I finished it in one ride. I'm a big fan of Rajinikanth, like everyone. So I read that book and there were so many things about Tamil cinema that I get to know, because I'm not from Tamil cinema and I've never been to Chennai or Tamil Nadu, so I was always intrigued by that cinema. And I'm a big fan of Joseph Vijay, Vikram, Surya, Kamal Haasan, all these film stars, and I've seen lots and lots of Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, Kannada films. So I wanted to know especially about this film called Bhasha, because Bhasha was one of the biggest blockbusters that Tamil cinema ever had. It is like the Sholay of Tamil cinema. The day it was released, it ran for 2-3 years after that. Everyone in Tamil Nadu, everyone who is Tamil, knows that have seen Bhasha and loves it. Bhasha was a film which actually raised the status of Rajinikanth to a godly level status. It was one of those films, one of those first films where the logo of Rajinikanth superstar comes in. It was started in Annamalai and it was also done by Suresh Krishna, which I get to know from the book. And the book tells you a lot of anecdotes about these two films, basically about Annamalai and Bhasha. And there are a few chapters on Veera as well, which he made in between, because Rajinikanth said that he doesn't want to star in two back-to-back action films. So he did a little bit of comedy film as well in between, which was not that successful as Annamalai and Bhasha. Annamalai was another film which was highly successful, and one of the most interesting trivia about that film was that the actual director of that film ran away 2-3 days before the principal shooting had to start. So Suresh Krishna was a new director who has directed 2-3 films which were successful, and he was an assistant of K. Balachandar, who was a producer of that film at that time. And Rajini was already signed, he has already given the dates and everything. And Suresh Krishna was called 2 days before the principal shooting had to start, and he was told that he has to direct this film, and there was no structured script of that film ready at that time. There were no songs ready at that time, because nothing was done, but the shooting had to be started because Rajinikanth has given the dates, and it was a big budget film. There were lots of money involved, there are lots of stars involved, every star has given the date, so the shooting cannot be stalled, it has to be done, and he has to do everything in 2 days. And just like Tim Ferriss said, what would you do if someone puts a gun to your head? You will start doing everything that is there to finish all your things. So he did everything in 2 days, and then he started a shooting. It was in a very haphazard manner, but it became one of the greatest films of Rajinikanth ever. And there's a scene which I have seen Annamalai before, I have seen Bhasha before, but there was a scene in Annamalai which I didn't know was so technically superb, which unless Suresh Krishna mentioned it in the book and I saw it later. There was a scene where Rajinikanth and the two other actors are standing there, and the camera moves in triangular manner around them, which was a very difficult, which is still a very difficult thing to do, and he has done it in 1992. So it was a very interesting thing and interesting TV. I think you should watch Annamalai just to understand the technicality of it. And there's another scene which is very famous where Rajinikanth actually says one of his most famous dialogues, Malai Da Annamalai, some dialogue like that. And he's going upstairs from a he's going upstairs from a staircase. And the villain who was once his friend and who has betrayed him is coming down, and it was a metaphor for Rajinikanth's rising and other guys down rising. It was shot in 1 hour. It was supposed to be shot in 8 hours, but the hotel didn't give them time, so director has to make up with whatever time they had, and he just shot 3-4 shots and later put them on editing and edited them in such a nice manner that you don't feel that it was shot in such a hasty manner. So those are the trivia that I get to know about Annamalai. But Bhasha is one film which I always liked. Why I liked it? Because of the structure. I don't care what the making is, I don't care about the over the top acting sometimes. There are some action sequences, there's technicality, loopholes, there are continuity jerks and all these things. But I don't care about all those things because that's Tamil cinema, and the actors there are larger than life. And there's a fight sequence, particular fight sequence, which I always love, which comes before the interval point. I don't like Bhasha after the interval, where the real Bhasha is introduced, but I like the transformation of that character where Rajinikanth is an auto driver and he's very subtle. He does not beat anyone, he does not lay his hands on anyone until unless the villain comes and starts beating his family, and then he shows his real face, which is Bhasha, where he can beat 10 goons with one hand. It is one of the most exciting sequences of Indian cinema, I believe, and one should watch it. And that's where the most famous dialogue for Arjun Khan also comes in. Na oru thalava sonna, na thalava sonna madri. I don't remember the dialogue, but it's somewhat like that. It's one of the most greatest dialogues. It means when I say it once, it means I say it 1,000 times. And I have seen the dialogue so many times. I've seen that fight sequence so many times on YouTube. I've seen first half of that Basha so many times that it just inside my mind. I haven't seen it in a Hindi dubbed manner. I have seen the Tamil version only. Nagma looks beautiful in that film. And that film was such a big blockbuster that Rajinikanth just blew everyone's mind. And there was no way he would get that much of a big blockbuster ever again. It was that big. It was the biggest thing that ever happened to Tamil cinema. I would suggest that you watch that film. I learned a lot while reading that book, and I would suggest that you buy that book and start reading it if you are a fan of Tamil cinema and also a fan of Rajinikanth, and you will understand how humble and nice person Rajinikanth is. Though I did feel that there was a problem that he was dominating a lot of decisions to the director, and the director was taking a lot of decisions asking him when actor should not be supposed to be taking decisions like that on set regarding direction. But Rajinikanth is Rajinikanth. He's one of the most powerful actors in cinema, and you cannot go against his will. So I don't blame anyone there. But if the film works, everything works, and he has understanding of what works and what does not work. So with that, I would like to say goodbye, and I would suggest that you read this book if you are a Tamil cinema fan. Some must read book. Thank you.